Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, I'm Prab. Today I will be walking you through to how to calculate your points for the Australian PR, especially focusing on the skill nominated visa subclass 190, which I applied for myself. Before we dive in, make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell for more videos like this. Please note, I'm not a migration agent and everyone's situation is unique, so do your own due diligence and research. By the end of this video, you will learn how to calculate your points for your PR application. Now let's talk about the points system. Australia uses a point-based system to assess skilled workers for permanent residency. Your score is based on factors like age, English language proficiency, skill, employment, education qualification, and other criteria, which we're going to discuss about later in this video. The higher your points, the stronger your PR application. So let's go step by step through how to calculate your points, and I'll share some tips along the way to boost your score. The first thing you need to do is to search for Australian PR point calculator in your browser. Make sure you click on the official Department of Home Affairs link to avoid unofficial or incorrect sites. Once you are on the official website, you will need to select a visa subclass. For today's video, I will focus on the skill nominated visa subclass 190, as I mentioned earlier, as this is the visa that I applied for. Once you select 190 visa, you will be able to access the point table, and now we will begin calculating how many points you might score. You can see in the screen there is a point table. There's a link to the point table which will show you how many points you can score in each category. If you want to explore each category in detail, open the point table in a new tab so you can refer to it as we go through the calculation. Please note that these point criteria are assessed at the time of invitation. So let's select and begin calculating our points. So the first thing is the age, which is one of the biggest factor in your point total. The point breakdown looks like this. So if your age bracket is between 18 to 25 years, you will get 25 points. You will get 30 points if you're in between 25 to 33 years. Again, you will get 25 points if you're in the age bracket of 33 to 40 years. And the age bracket of 40 to 45 years get 15 points. So which means that the 25 to 33 year is the sweet spot where you can earn the most points. When I applied, I was in the age band of 25 to 33 years old, so I'll select this for today's video and make sure you choose the band that applies to you. Now we move on to the English language skills. For the 190 visa, you need to demonstrate one of the three levels of English proficiency, which is the competent English, proficient English, and superior English. For competent English, you will get 0 points. For proficient English, you will get 10 points, and for superior English, you will get 20 points. And you can take tests like IELTS or VTE to prove your skills. For example, to achieve competent English, which is for IELTS, you need to get 6 in each part. For your listening, speaking, reading, and writing. And similarly for PTE, you need to get 50 in each part. For proficient, you need to get 7 in each part for IELTS and 65 in each part for PTE. And for superior English, you need to get 8 in each part for IELTS, and for PTE, 79 in each part. If you want to know more about English language skill requirement, you can click onto this link, or you can read on the point table for more information. And to know more about each component, you can watch this video. Also, please note that as you can see that for your competent English, you will get no points, 0 points, but you're still eligible to apply for 190 visa. However, if your score is less than competent English, then you may not be eligible for applying 190 visa. When I applied, I aimed for superior English score. I knew that a higher score could make my application more stronger, especially when everyone told me getting a PR in public health is just impossible or highly difficult. So I tried my best to get the highest score, which is the superior English. So in my case, I'll select the superior English from the drop down. I will highly recommend you aiming for a higher score. I know it is difficult, but you know, if I can do it, you can do it too. There are tons of classes and online resources available to help you to achieve this. Now moving on to the work experience, you can earn points for both overseas and Australian work. For overseas, if your experience is less than 3 years, you will get 0 points. If your work experience is less than 3 to 5 years, you will get 5 points. If your work experience is between 5 to 8 years, you will get 10 points. And if your work is 8 years, you will get 15 points. And for similarly for Australian work experience, if you have work experience less than 1 year, you will get 0 points. But if you have work experience between 1 to 3 years, you will get 5 points. Between 3 to 5 years, you will get 10 points. And 5 to 8 years, you will get 15 points. And highest point if you have work experience for 8 years, which will be 20 points. So in my case, I will not get any point for overseas work experience because I only worked less than 1 year in India. So I will not get any point for that. But for Australian work experience, I will get 5 points because when I was applying for my permanent residency, I had work experience for more than 1 year. So I will select this category, work experience between 1 to 3 years, and this will give me 5 points. And make sure you select the right experience from the drop down. Before we move to the next category, the one thing that I wanted to mention is that in total you will only get 20 points, right, from combining for your work experience from overseas and your Australia. So the total you will get 20 points. Now for education, points you earn depend on your highest level of qualification. For example, you will get 20 points if you have a doctorate from an Australian education institution or a doctorate from another institution that meets the recognized standard. You will get 15 points if you have at least a bachelor's or master's degree either from an Australian institution or from another recognized institution overseas, and you will get 10 points for a diploma or trade qualification from an Australian education institution, and you will get 10 points if you hold a qualification or award recognized by the relevant assessing authority for your nominated skill occupation, showing that it is suitable for that occupation. For my application, I had a master's degree from Australia, so I'll select the second option from the drop down. Please note that you only get point for your highest qualification, so make sure you choose the right one from the drop down. If you are unsure whether your overseas qualification will be recognized, you can reach out to the VITASIS to verify whether your overseas qualification is valid as per the Australian qualification standard. More info is available on their website. I will put the link of the VITASIS website in the description section. Now moving on to the Australian study requirement, if you have completed at least one degree, diploma or trade qualification from an Australian education institution and it meets the Australian study requirement, you will earn 5 points. I studied full-time at an Australian university, so I selected yes here. Be sure to select the option if you meet the requirement, and if you want to know more about this, you can click to this link. The next section is specialist education qualification, which they are looking for if you have a master's degree by research or a doctorate degree from an Australian education institution that included at least 2 academic years study in a relevant field. If yes, you may be eligible for 10 points. But the degree needs to meet the certain criteria. For this, you must have completed at least 2 years academic years of study in one of the following fields. If your degree falls into any of these areas and was awarded after completing at least 2 years of study, then you might be eligible for these points. However, I do not have any of these qualifications, so I selected no. But if you do, it is a great way to earn extra points. Now, next one is community language, which is NATI exam. If you hold a credential community language qualification, like being certified by NATI, you can earn additional 5 points. For example, if you are certified translator in community language like Hindi, Punjabi, Mandarin, or Spanish, and you have been accredited by NATI, you can add 5 points to your PR application. I gave my NATI exam in Punjabi. These additional points are incredibly valuable, so I highly recommend taking the NATI exam in your community language if possible. There are many languages available, so make sure to check the NATI website for details. You can find more information about this test on their official website, and for that you can click here. Another way to earn 5 points is if you have completed your studies in regional Australia, but there are few criteria you need to meet. You must have at least 1 degree, diploma or trade qualification that meet the standard Australian study requirement. You need to have lived and studied in a designated regional area while attending a campus in that area. It doesn't include any study that was done by a distance education. So if you have completed your degree while living and studying in regional areas, you can add these 5 points to your PR application. Study in regional area is an excellent way to boost your points total. Unfortunately, I did not earn any point here because I studied in Melbourne, which is not considered as a regional area. Therefore, I will select no. But if you have studied in a designated regional area, make sure to claim these points. Now, let's talk about partner skills. If your spouse or de facto partner is applying for the same visa, that can help you gain additional points depending on their skill and qualification. Here is how it works. As you can see here, to get the full 10 points, your partner must have under 45 years old, they had a competent English skills, had nominated occupation that's on the same skill occupation list as yours, and they had a suitable skill assessment from the relevant authority. And remember, this assessment should not be for subclass 485 visa. If your spouse or partner meets the English requirement only, you can still earn 5 points. If you are single or your partner is an Australian citizen or permanent resident, you can claim the full 10 points as well. Keep in mind, if your marital status changes during the processing of your visa, the point for this category could also change. In my case, I was single when I applied, so I will select the third option. If you have a partner, be sure to select the relevant option for them. Now let's talk about the professional year program and how it can help you earn 5 extra points towards your PR application. If you have completed a professional year in accounting, ICT, computing or engineering in Australia and it was in your nominated occupation or a closely related occupation, you are eligible to claim these points. But there are a few things that you need to keep in mind. First, the program must have been at least 12 months long and it need to have been completed in Australia within the 4 years before you were invited to apply for PR. So if you completed your professional year within the last 48 months, you can count it even if you have started the program earlier. It is also important that your professional year was provided by one of the recognized organization in the following list below. If you have completed a professional year in Australia, don't forget to claim these 5 points. I did not complete a professional year as it is not required in my field, so I will go back and select no. Now moving on to the nomination. If you have been nominated by an Australian state or territory to apply for subclass 190, you will get 5 points for that, and that nomination remains valid and you will earn 5 points. The nomination essentially supports your PR application by confirming that the state or territory sees a demand for your occupation, giving your application an extra boost. I received my nomination from the Victorian state when I applied for PR and this earned me 5 points. When you submit your expression of interest, you will automatically get these points. Be sure to select yes if you have been nominated, but if you apply for 491, you will get 15 points from the government. Now moving on to the final point breakdown. Once you have completed all these sections, you will get a final point breakdown. As you see in the screen, I earned 30 points for the age, 20 points for English language skills, and I got 0 points for work experience outside Australia, 5 points for Australian work experience, 15 points for my master's degree, and 0 for specialist education qualification, as I did not have any specialist education in research, and 5 points for Australian study requirement, 5 points for NATI exam or community language, 0 for study in regional Australia, 10 points for single, and 0 for professional year in Australia, and 5 points for state nomination. This gave me a total of 95 points. Remember, the higher your point, the stronger your application. So aim for the best possible score. What is your point total so far? Drop in the comment section and let me know. That's all for today's video. If you are applying for other visas like 189 or 491, the process for calculating point is the same. Just select the right visa subclass. In the coming weeks, I will be releasing a video on how to submit your expression of interest for the 190 visa. Make sure to subscribe so you don't miss that. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like and don't forget to subscribe for more updates. If you have any questions, drop them in the comment section and share this video with anyone who might find it useful. Thanks for watching and good luck with your PR journey, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.